Panos, or Panayiotis Chamakiotis, was born in Greece with studies as agricultural engineer and specialization in soil science at Aristotle University of Thessaloniki. Today, lives in Barcelona, where serves the COMPO EXPERT Group as regional director of Europe, Middle East, and Africa. He's passionate in settling connecting platforms for the creation and capture of added value for his associates. He doggedly supports continuous evolution with influence, guidance, and development of operational groups, and he's working with, based on the vision, setting, strategic direction, improvement of personal weaknesses, knowledge from failure, speed of decision-taking, knowledge of the market's environment, preparation, and proactivity for achieving ambitious goal. He's the author of the book, The Challenges of Modern Agriculture in 7 Languages. And last but not least, he's the initiator of the Kiss My Crops in the Culture Project. Welcome, Panos, to Kiss My Crops TV.
Good morning, Christos. How are you doing?
Fantastic. And I'm going directly to the question, agriculture or agri-food?
Well, if we travel by train, do we say that this company belongs to the train or transportation sector? If we eat a hamburger from a canteen outside, do we say that this small company, enterprise, belongs to canteen or to the food sector? This more than ever, Christos, is obvious for each one of us now. If now we evidence that supply of healthy food is important when a problem, a catastrophe, as COVID hits the nations, the marketplaces, then it's a proof that food and agriculture are exactly at the same line when we talk about the industry and its global impact. I think this is my answer.
Quite impressive. Okay. You know, that most of the people, they say that you are in the fertilizers business. But from the marketing point of view, is there any difference between fertilizer sectors and food chain sector as you declare the last 10 years?
Well, this is my favorite subject, as you know. Well, farmers, Christos, network of scientists, manufacturers, etc., continuously direct their energy, their efforts to develop the best growing and living conditions for crops to feed the population. Fertilizers, as one of the main inputs for this industry, plays a significant role to match quality, to match quantity of crops for contributing to the smooth and healthy characteristics of the food chain. Today's consumers are no longer satisfied with a blind system, with a blind feeding system. And the crops' modern nutrition method, as today's fertilizers stand, are the necessary component to achieve such a knowledge and advanced result. Because today's fertilizers are pointing to the more with less principle, smart crop nutrition, which influence properly the physiology, the phenological stages to improve the qualitative characteristics of the crop, is the key, Christos, to avoid excessive use of pesticides, to improve exponentially the productivity of farms and serve significantly the farm-to-fork concept of European food chain process. Fertilizers is the food of our food, so of the crops.
Yeah, quite a great distinction between them. It is about the way of thinking, way of understanding the market. But you know, yes, it is okay. But now we face a very big challenge ahead of us. Some people, they had big disaster. It is some close there. Well, I'm talking about the COVID-19 pandemic and how this COVID will influence the agri-food sector from now and on.
Well, this and next period will be extremely difficult for the global economy. Although COVID hit less and even increased a lot the importance of farmers and agriculture in consumers' perception, this passage from the crisis won't be wrinkles free for any sector. We have been set back about 25 years in about 25 weeks. But this pandemic also provides a turning point in global agri-food. And set against the nightmare scenario, COVID has also the potential to usher in a renaissance that will ultimately drive economy recovery, make us healthier and heal our planet at the end. Perhaps the most important step governments can take now due to the pandemic to advance agri-food sector is to make a comprehensive change in their perspective, in their approach to their policy, which often have been failed to recognize the social, environmental, and economic advantages of modern agriculture. The accelerated flow of healthy foods, services, and skills is one of the principal reasons for the most rapid reduction of global poverty. And now this must prevail and secure, strengthen in the recovery phase by ensuring the sustainability of the farmers. My tagline, Christos, is progress is possible, but not inevitable. And I stand by it. How bad the pandemic gets and how long it lasts is largely within the world control. Mm-hmm. Ultimately, businesses in the sector must really believe that the future is not a zero-sum contest in which winners win only when losers lose. No, healthy agri-food is a cooperative endeavor in which we all make progress together.
Let's now go into the point. Let's get a little bit inter-corporate, because I'd like to ask you, from the corporate point of view, how the agri-technicians of COMPO EXPERT, at least in EMEA region that you are responsible, will influence the future of agri-food as you described?
Mm-hmm. This is a very good question. COMPO EXPERT puts sustainability in the core of the business, and we are concerned a lot for the sustainable management of natural resources and of the necessary actions we need to proactively take for climate changes by achieving balance and qualitative development of crop yields. This exactly is our role. And being the global converters, Christos, of commodities fertilizers and of past practices into specialities, into crop environmental friendly solutions, we hope that we influence the agri-food chain positively by providing such added value solutions for the food of highest quality and safety. Particularly important for us is the tribute to the role of research, knowledge, innovation, and digitization of the agriculture in order to enhance efficiency in production.
You talk a lot about innovations, but you know, there are so many innovations out there right now that claim that they will save the future of agriculture and or the agri-food chain in general. What categories of those innovations you think will be adapted from the market the next 3 years?
Well, as you know, I don't have my crystal ball with me. But yes, the smart thing to do is to predict the future, not to stuck in the present. Now, we all know that a lot of structural deficiencies have undermined the competitive advantages of the agri-food sector. No need to deep dive here. And we all know that in the future, the nations will focus in this sector on based on growth and employment on sustainability. In my opinion, agri-food and agrotech are both technological challenges. They're both technological challenges of the agri-food sector. So intelligent agriculture, organic farming, adoption of new technologies, mainly through young entrepreneurship, embracement of more with less rule, agroecology, stricter conditions for food safety. These are the future innovations, which a lot of these are already laying on our table. I see, as you know, agriculture as a holistic service platform of absolute solutions, which will be provided by experts rather than as an industry with only products are being marketing just for profit, but without added value for the ecosystem. The role of future agriculture is much more than this. What matters in life is not the mere fact that we have lived. It is the difference we have made in the lives of others that will also determine the importance of the life we live. Agriculture and agri-food meant to make this difference. So, agricultural models will be adapted to the new landscape an old-fashioned model will shrink. The future of agriculture is in absolute harmony with nature, rural world, and public health, and innovation has to point on this direction. Uncontrolled growth must be curtailed, and the proper relation between environment and society, ecology and economy must triumph.
Quite interesting. And from innovation now, I'm going to nail a little bit a very sensitive question. And I'm talking about the female power. I'm talking about the women in the society and in our business as well. Back in 2016, you participated in a panel about the women entrepreneurship and intrapreneurship. I mean, the women that they are working inside a corporation. But I have one more question. What are your thoughts on agripreneurship? I mean, entrepreneurship in the agricultural sector today about the female power, as I ask.
You know that I'm aware of the obstacles that women have to overcome in this environment. When it comes to leading agri-food businesses, only 28% of the women in the sector are managers or have top level positions and responsibilities in agricultural and also in livestock farms in the European Union. Imagine now with the crisis caused by COVID, how the situation is getting worse. I do believe that agripreneurship, as you mentioned, needs women. What kind of women? Women with passion, ideas, and answers to the challenges that the agri-food sector has to face for the society of the 21st century. The corporate ecosystems must help to reinforce female leadership by supporting women with ideas and startups leading by women in initial phases in the sector. I think this is the answer. Mm-hmm.
So we started with food chain, then we went to coronavirus pandemic, then we discussed about innovation, now for the female power. And now I'm daring to ask you about the new generation. What direction must choose the young generation of, you know, the agronomists, the agriculturists, the people that they now wondering if they have to study on this sector. Okay, what direction must choose? In which direction from now and on? You told us about so many innovations and so many directions. What's your opinion?
I highlighted before, that the young entrepreneurship is one of the most important key for the future development of agri-food sector. But you know, Christos, even the best diary can milk a vulture. So no matter good they are, how much they want to be better matters, unless age is just a number. At the end, passion and attitude always make the difference in any profession. If individuals from young generations that want to involve in agriculture are PhD equipped, so passion, hunger, and drive, and are not afraid to experiment, they will not fail no matter specific direction they will follow. You give me the opportunity to say here that agriculture is one of the few places that welcomes everyone. Backgrounds from farmers to agronomists, from ecologists, engineers, economists, environmentalists, to food experts, and animal experts, everybody with or without any degree has a reason to be here. Agriculture is a place for everyone to participate if you want. Mm-hmm. They need young generation. They need to escape from the old perception about agriculture, this old figure with the farmer, and to realize that this is a very attractive sector with great potential, with a lot of interfaces to many other sectors and sciences, where you might not be rich in a few years, but you definitely have prosperity, successful duration, and gaining for many years if you are willing to work hard and out of boundaries. Change is the only constant in our life, no matter where we operate, no matter what we are doing for a living. It's going to happen. what each of us can influence is how we manage it for the better. So this is my, not advice, but my opinion about the young generation, that they need to rediscover agriculture, the modern agriculture.
Quite a positive message, quite positive message. But I like to insist a little bit. There is high demand about new ideas. And if we go back to the technology sector 30 years back, we can see about the startup ecosystem. They started some new companies that they revolutionized all the whole now digital, let's say, sector.
Yeah.
The last, let's say, 5 years, there are a lot of discussions about the startup ecosystem around agriculture or agri-food. Okay. If you believe on this, about the entrepreneurship in agriculture as a startup, and I'm not talking only about the young generation, I mean the new entrants in that sector, but we have to wait from them. And which would be their role in the entrepreneurial community?
Yes, yes. Startups, it's a big topic. This is a big global trend nowadays, but also the last at least 5 years or maybe decade in agriculture. A wealth of such initiatives are all going in developing countries to supply local markets with products. That's the power of true entrepreneurial spirit as the sector grows. Startup actors are leading partnerships with the sector to build market infrastructure, integrate sustainable agriculture into extension programs, and discover or forge or even grasp market opportunities. Combining cutting edge technologies with a true entrepreneurialist mindset, the whole sector is disrupting the traditional inspection, and this is extremely important, refreshing and healthy. Good entrepreneurs always are improving real impact value, economical impact, and at the end, environmental impact of infrastructure, and they are building assets. Of course, Christos, on the other hand, startups need to understand that they should better think about their own value proposition rather than looking after benchmark and easy growth. They should embrace sustainable practices and focus on long-term value, because there is short-term value in long-term thinking. Agriculture always pays off, but is not a place where someone can be, in my opinion, can be rich fast in a few time. You have to wait, and the young generation and startups, they have to consider this point where they're making business in this sector.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. So you shared with us a lot of ideas about the external environment of your organization, but I have one question about your organization internally. And the question is, you are working for a so-called international company group. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but how important is the culture understanding among all those different, let's say, cultures in such a global organization as a COMPO EXPERT group?
Culture. Well, you know the famous quote, culture eats strategy for breakfast. I say culture is before any structure and any strategy. We need to understand that we make ourselves up of two pieces when we make business. We are supposedly both moral and economic at the same time. And therefore, it is very important each time that these double pieces of ourselves are smoothly combined, so that the result of another one comes out in which we are reborn. This is a culture within the business, and this is extremely essential for any result, but also to tap, to retain and develop talents. When you have a good culture in organization, and in our company, we looking after seriously after this leads you to yourself at the end. The bad leader, for instance, Christos, because the leader is always shaping and spreading the culture in an organization. So the bad leader is the one who manipulates you at the end and destroys the culture within an organization. On the other hand, a good leader who spreads healthy culture is like a good teacher. They both turn you over to yourself and say, open wings. By the way, culture that does not only eat strategy for breakfast, as they say, but also for lunch, dinner, etc.
Thank you very much. We are approaching to ending of this conversation and discussion. You're fantastic in the interview, but I have one question about our common project that you are giving this interview, and how you imagine the role of the Kiss My Crops project in the forthcoming years, as you described about the expert in your in the company's name, about the crop centering, about the food chain, as you said, how you imagine your role?
You agree, I suppose, that as long as we do not fully trust the possibilities of knowledge, we move on to the need for understanding. Possibilities differ, understanding is different. It's only with potential that we dive off a cliff. Understanding will stop us, correct?
Mm-hmm.
So Kiss My Crop KMC platform and initiative is all about understanding of different crop characteristics in different countries. Understanding of good crop practices, at the end, understanding of different cultures and regarding crop stories and how to promote, multiply, at the end, copy successfully, implement successfully cases, these cases, and this exam of extroverted entrepreneurs who constantly innovate in the sector and do groundbreaking acting. Kiss My Crop initiative is powered by COMPO EXPERT and will further assist our organization to shift from product to crop and customer-centric approach. For this interactive communication platform, my vision is to connect in the future with harmony and to sponsor properly the crop stories from different countries, from different farmers and customers, by giving them back, on the other hand, the keys of knowledge, so the COMPO EXPERT tools for more efficient production in order to promote at the end the best methodology for them to produce healthy food for the sake of the social and environmental well-being. This is my vision for Kiss My Crop platform, and this is the status of the initiative today.
Panos, we reached the end of this conversation. I would like to thank on behalf of all the followers of the Kiss My Crops project, and one big thank to you for your time and especially about your ideas. Thank you very much and wish all this situation with COVID to be, let's say, something that we will leave it behind as soon as possible.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Christos, for your time. Thank you for this interview, and you're right. We need to stay safe, to stay, let's say, strong, and to face the next day, the next phase with more optimism. Thank you very much. Take care.